So the correct diagnosis here is C, cystic nodal metastasis in the right side of the neck. So first of all, location. You can see that this cystic mass is posterior to the subandibular gland and anterior medial to the sternocleidomastoid mastoid muscle and anterior and lateral to the carotid space. So by location alone, this is actually a classic location for second branchial cleft cyst. So location for that is good. However, remember this patient is a 50-year-old male. So the branchial cleft cysts tend to occur in kids. So whenever you see a cystic nodal mass in adults, you need to be very careful about label this as branchial cleft cyst because more likely this is going to turn out to be cystic nodal metastasis until proven otherwise. There are other features that's concerning for this being just a simple branchial cleft cyst. You can see the wall is relatively thick, it's not a thin wall. And more importantly, or more suspiciously, you do see a enhanced immune lodge within. So overall look is very suspicious for a something that's more aggressive than just branchial cleft cyst. So cystic nodal metastasis is the best answer here. And on the accompanying PET-CT, you can see not only the cystic nodal metastasis itself is there's a strong uptake. You can see the source of the lesion is come from the oropharyngeal carcinoma, especially ones with HPV positive oropharyngeal squamous cell carcinoma. They can present with cystic nodal metastasis. Other type of cancer, such as thyroid cancer, can also present with cystic nodal metastasis. So the best answer here is C. What about other choice that doesn't work as well? As I mentioned earlier, if this is a young patient, and choice B is actually going to be the best answer, being that this is a classic location for second branchial cleft cyst, posterior to this submandibular gland, anterior to the SCM, and lateral to the carotid space. And second branchial cleft cyst, as you know, is by far the most common branchial cleft anomaly, account for more than 90% of the time. Other types, the first, third, and fourth, they are comparatively much rare. So in real life, you're not going to see a lot of the first branchial cleft cysts. For first branchial cleft cysts, they tend to occur around the ear, so around the pinna, or by the external auditory canal, or there's a connection between external auditory canal to the angle of the mandible. So that will be the classic location for choice A. For choice B, we already talked about it. If this is a kid, that would be the best answer, although you should remain suspicious for the fact that you do see an enhancing mural nodule, unless perhaps patient has prior infection associated with second branchial cleft cyst. Thyroglossal duct cysts tend to be midline or just off midline, so they can occur anywhere between foramen cecum in back of the tongue or in the tongue base, all the way down to the thyroid gland. So they tend to stay in the midline or off midline, usually within 2 centimeters. So this is not a great location for thyroglossal ductal cysts. For abscess, you can see that there's really not a lot of inflammation around this lesion. You can see the fat plane remained relatively well preserved. So it makes kind of little sense to see no inflammatory response for an active abscess. So that's also not the best choice. So overall, the correct diagnosis here is going to be nodal metastasis. I hope that's helpful. Good luck on your board exam. Thank you.